Biden announcing that he's going to be signing an executive order setting a pretty ambitious target of 50% of electric vehicles to be sold in the United States by the year 2030. Joining us right now in a Squawk exclusive with more on that announcement is Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg. And Secretary Buttigieg, thanks for being here today. I'm really glad to have you here because I'm confused by what I've read about this. Is this an executive order mandating that 50% of cars in the United States have to be electric by the year 2030? Is this a voluntary thing that the top players in the industry are kind of stepping up and say they'd like to see 40 to 50%? I've read a lot of different confusing things.
Right. Yeah. Let me help break it down. So it doesn't function as a mandate, but it does create the conditions for us to meet that goal. We have got to act. The transportation sector is the biggest part of our economy emitting greenhouse gases, and cars and trucks are one of the biggest parts of that. So this goal of getting half of our new vehicles to be electric within the decade is going to be urgently needed for us to meet the imperative of climate in our time. Now, in terms of how it works, you got the executive order that sets that overall direction, the policy of the federal government, and then it challenges all of the different agencies, including mine, to take steps that are consistent with that, including a step that we've been working on actually from almost day one that we're prepared to announce today, which is new corporate average fuel economy or CAFE standards. These are ambitious, they are aggressive, but they're also feasible, and they're going to require that fuel efficiency increases by about 8% a year in the next model years. Now, meanwhile, you've got EPA. They have the authority to regulate tailpipe emissions and the pollution coming out of vehicles. They're going to make an announcement, too. So basically what you have here is all of the different pulleys and levers of the federal government working in the same direction toward a very ambitious and very urgently needed goal.
We just spoke with Lynn Good, the CEO of Duke Energy, and one of the points I was making to her was that administrations come and go, and if they have a polar opposite sort of goals, it can be like whiplash to an industry that's trying to invest for, let's say, a decade at a time, spending lots of capital expenditures going into this. Maybe what's more important is what the industry itself is saying it will propose to do. And you've got big players like GM, Ford, and Stellantis saying that their goal will be to have it there by 40 to 50% of their sales be electric vehicles by the year 2030 if the administration spends billions of dollars trying to make that happen. Is that something that's going to happen? The billions of dollars they want, it'd be for manufacturing, for research, for making sure that there's actually electric vehicle charging stations throughout the country. That's a big difference.
That's right. You really need to have policy, industry, and importantly, labor pulling in the same direction. And that's what you're going to see today at the White House. Industry is stepping up, recognizing that there is a business as well as a moral imperative to do something. We are setting the tone and setting the regulations at the federal level. And we're also seeing workers looking at how more jobs can be created through this transition to EVs. It's pretty clear that this transition is going to happen. This is where the world is going. So the big question for us is, how much of it's going to happen here? Is the electric vehicle future going to be built by American firms on American soil with American workers, or are other countries going to get ahead of us? And that competitiveness piece is a really big factor here. As you say, there's been a lot of whipsawing. The previous administration really acted to dramatically weaken the standards that were already underway. But what we have now is not only making clear what this administration's policy is, but being aligned with industry that recognizes that this is the future. And a lot depends on how quickly we can get to that future state of greener, cleaner cars, which, by the way, also means a lot of consumer savings. We estimate about $900 in savings over the lifetime of a vehicle for a family that purchases it, thanks to these higher expectations that we're laying down today.